हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम सतीश परियानी, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल, वॉल्चन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, शोलापुर। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द कंसेप्ट ऑफ फ्रेंचाइजिंग। लर्निंग आउटकम एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशंस, यू विल एबल टू एक्सप्लेन एंड यूज द बिजनेस एक्सपेंशन टूल विच इज कॉल्ड फ्रेंचाइजिंग। द कंटेंट्स वॉट विल बी कवर्ड विल बी, first of all, basic knowledge of franchising, what are types of franchising, what are the benefits of franchising and the problem associated with franchising, and finally the references. First of all, we'll understand what does franchising mean. The definition given by International Franchisee Association is: a franchisee operation is a contractual relationship between the franchisor and franchisee, in which the franchisor offers or is obliged to maintain a continuing interest in the business of franchisee in such areas as know-how and training, wherein the franchisee operates under the common trade name, format and or procedure owned or controlled by franchisor, and which franchisee has or will make substantial capital investment in his business from his own resources. Franchising actually is more than a distributorship. It extends to an entire operation or method of the business. It has greater assistance, control, and it is generally of longer durations. Distributor merely resells products to retailers or customers. Franchisee, as we all know, the biggest example is given in the world is called McDonald's. You see, they extend support to the entire operation or method of the business. And generally, the person who goes in deal with this franchisee has longer durations. Whereas in distributorship, the company many times has a channel, physical product they sell through distributor, which only resells the products at their profit in it, and which is further resold by retailers and customers. Now, as I given one example of franchisee, McDonald's. Now you think, which vada pav company, we all eat vada pavs, right? So which vada pav company, a firm, is done franchising? Now, generally, there are three main types of franchising which are being done. First one is called product distribution franchise. Second one is business format franchise. Third one is management franchise. Franchises are done on the basis of three different types, whether it is product, whether it is a business format, or it is management. Let us see certain examples in this regard. Now you tell me, Coca-Cola, Exxon, OSIM are examples of which? They are the examples of product distribution franchising. As we all know, Coca-Cola, Exxon, OSIM are the example of product distribution franchising. Now we'll go with this, the American food, McDonald's, Hilton, KFC, Subway, Starbucks coffee, Long John Silver's are the example of, these are the famous example of business format franchise. And generally, we see this type of franchisee is much, much powerful because the entire business is being franchised. We all know the success stories of McDonald's, the success stories of KFCs, the success stories of Starbucks coffee, not only in India, but each and every corner, they are doing a very good business. Now, the last franchisee example is American Idol, where it is a famous management franchisee. The franchisee provides a management expertise, format and or procedures for conducting the business. Let us say, tomorrow it can happen that our Kaun Banega Crorepati, KBC, can become a big example in this regard, a management franchisee. Now, what are the benefits of franchising? The first and foremost benefit of franchisees offer the independence of small businesses ownership supported by the benefits of big business network. As we can see in the example of McDonald's, a big name is associated with them and independence a small organization is working. You don't necessarily need business experience to run a franchisee. Franchisers usually provide the training you need to operate their business model. Franchisees have a higher rate of success than startup. It has been observed over a period because, see, this sentence is truly valid, we can say, because it is having support from big organizations, support from their experiences. So whenever they support this kind of with their experience, with their knowledge, with their processes, the failure rates are too much less, we can say. Because they have already taken care of certain unwanted sudden issues which can creep up in the business. You may find it easier to secure finance for franchisee. It may cost less to buy a franchisee than start your own business at the same time. Franchisee, just you have to pay some franchisee fee and they support you with their processes, their support, their business model. But when you are starting a new startup, you are starting with from the scratch. So what happens? The cost associated or the risk associated with the franchising business is far less comparatively with your new startup. Again, these are having certain advantages also and certain disadvantages also. Now, what are the problems associated with franchising? The first and foremost problem associated with franchising is having sufficient capital. Many businesses fail due to undercapitalization, and the same is true for the new franchisee. Suppose there is a new business which want to do his franchising, he can raise the issue. He can fail purely due to undercapitalization and because of insufficient capital available with them. The second foremost important is building a solid infrastructure. Solid infrastructure means a franchising business, if it is not built on the solid infrastructure basis, it can fail, it can truly fail it. Then, bringing the right franchisee on board. Building a solid relationships. Many times, when the franchising business is being done, there are certain conditions, there is certain agreements done between franchisor and franchisee. The conditions such as you should not sell another product in their store. Let us say the example of McDonald's. In McDonald's, you cannot sell other, we can say, vada paos or certain wafers of other brand, even though they are famous. But many times a franchisee to, we cannot say cheat, but it can to enhance his or to support his what he can say margins, if the business is not running good or something, many times to improve his profitability, he starts selling. So there can be a issues between franchisor and franchisee. So there should be a solid relationship between the franchisor and franchisee. Again, we have to bring the right staff on the board. If the staff is not correct, the problems again are faced at a different level. Now, another role is understanding the role of franchisor. Means many times it has been seen that we need to change certain furniture levels or certain infra or certain positions in our franchisee business. So it also needs that training, timely training, or if the product changed by franchisor or some taste changed by franchisor, let us say McDonald's today is operating with some burgers and pizzas. So suddenly if it starts want to sell certain chips or wafers, they put in new product. So they need to give some training to the at lower level, and parallelly they need to understand whether that product really will be running on the stores all over the places or at some places. They need to be very clear. So what is the role of franchisee? Being very clear in that case. Also, the finding the right time is the basic process of franchising. Where right time, right place, again it is said, generally McDonald's see when they give their franchisee, they see at what is the location, what is the area available, and generally they see whether that area is your name or it is on rented. They have certain conditions, certain clauses. We need to meet that clauses and then come up with that kind of businesses. So certain references used from NPTEL and franchisedirect.com and the business GOV world.